So today we've got Ryan Hageman joining us. He's the Global AI Policy Issue Lead. Ryan, welcome to MOE.
Oh, great to be here. Thanks for having me, Tim.
So I know we want to scramble this segment because this news just broke yesterday, which is that the White House has released its AI action plan, which is sort of a national strategy for artificial intelligence. And I know there's a lot going on. I was looking at the document this morning, just like a lot of different recommendations. Do you want to just walk us through, like, what is this exactly? And is it important? Like, should we be paying attention to it?
Yeah, sure. I mean, I'll walk you back backwards. The answer to the second question is absolutely. Yes, very. This is something that not only IBM, but pretty much everyone in industry and here in DC and frankly around the world has been anticipating and looking forward to for basically the last 6 months since it was originally announced. It's in a way, yeah, this is policy Super Bowl for policy nerds and policy wonks. But the short version is what this document basically does is it lays out the Trump administration's policy agenda as it relates to artificial intelligence. And part of the reason I think you haven't seen so much action in Congress is this is also the starter pistol for legislative action in the future. Probably not by the end of this year, but probably moving into next year. But what is the plan? I mean, in short, the plan is basically how the administration wants this Congress and the existing agency apparatus in DC to approach thinking about AI. So there's something on the order of about 135 individual actions that are recommended agencies take. This plan was also accompanied by three executive orders from the president, which he signed yesterday. Which provides a little bit more clarity on what exactly some of the agencies are supposed to do with respect to some of the more important features of the plan. But basically, the plan, as outlined, goes a little bit something like this. There's three pillars. There's accelerating AI innovation. There's building out American AI infrastructure. And then there's leading in international AI diplomacy and security. And what this basically boils down to for IBM is a lot of positive momentum. I think the big thing for us is there was a specific call out on the value and the importance of open source and open weight model development and deployment, which is frankly something that we've been asking for from the administration and from Congress. It's one of our major pillars that we advocate for here in DC, the need for policymakers to make sure that the open space and the open community kind of remains hands-off from policymakers.
That's like a big shift, right? It kind of feels like for a little bit there was sort of a debate over, well, we've got these powerful new technologies. Is it kind of unsafe for them to be open? And it feels like here they're kind of very much affirmatively saying, no, like we want open. We actually think that's like a really important thing to happen. So it feels like almost like there's kind of a shift in that discussion. And, you know, it's landing very firmly on the side of open, which I think I'm personally very excited about.
Yeah, I mean, me too. And I think a lot of us at IBM would view that as a very positive development. I would say where it kind of moved us from was a space of uncertainty because no one really knew how the administration was going to come down on this. The last administration never really took a super strong stand. There was a great report from the Department of Commerce that looked at open model weight development, didn't make any, you know, super strong statements, but it also didn't say open source bad, right? Which was kind of a win at the time because of the uncertainty. So it's a little bit of sea change shift, if only from moving from neutral to positive. But it's a big positive and it's a big, you know, signal for us in industry that kind of this direction that we've been taking is now essentially getting a little bit of kudos from policymakers, which will be good for the next few years of administrative action.
And so you mentioned that there was these executive orders that were signed. I think one of them had to do with like energy. I know IBM, we've all frequently on MOE, we're talking about the compute build out and infrastructure side of this. Sounds like there's been kind of like a kind of clear path to really build a lot more, it seems like.
Yeah, I mean, that was the gist of the not only the section on energy and data center build out in the plan, but in the executive order as well. And it basically, it doesn't touch IBM so much because we're not really in the data center build out game, but we definitely benefit from more data centers, right? More, you know, energy capacity on the grid. That executive order basically just streamlines a lot of regulatory approval processes. It gets kind of in the weed, references a lot of different statutory authorities and existing legislation. But the short version of it is basically to the extent that there are opportunities for us to be building more capacity on the grid, to be building more data centers, the federal government shouldn't be standing in the way of that. They should be finding opportunities to help expedite that and make it happen quicker because, you know, America's going to need a lot more energy if we're going to be doing a lot more LLMs in the future.
Yeah, for sure. Anything else that you were pleased to see? It sounds like you focus kind of a lot on the open side. Anything else that you think kind of is in this action plan that like there's stuff that folks should focus on or even kind of pick up the PDF and read?
Yeah, I mean, too much to mention in a couple minutes, but I do think the one other thing that really struck a chord with me was under the AI diplomacy bucket, there's essentially a dictate for the Department of Commerce to figure out with partners in industry how to kind of create a larger export package of a full American AI tech stack, right? So everything from data center build out to, you know, model developers, model deployers, get everyone together in an industry consortium, essentially package that all together so that the Department of Commerce can then use those essentially export packages to push out American tech to the rest of the world. And something that we've said a lot that this administration can do in AI is really promote that idea of exporting American AI and American technology. So, you know, that's an opportunity for IBM. We'll see what comes of it. But that I would say is the other really big call out here that really IBM, I think, and I hope stands to benefit from over the next year or two.
That's great. Well, I know we just have a few minutes left. Action plan is out. Executive orders have been signed. What comes next? Are we? I assume you're not saying, well, we're all done with this AI thing here in DC.
Yeah, I mean, I kind of wish I could take vacation for the next rest of the year, but I think the reality is there's a lot of requests for information that are going to be, you know, this. The AI action plan basically says, here's what we're going to do. Now they actually have to do it, which means we've got a lot of responses to provide. We've got a lot more education and engagements to do on the Hill as they think about legislative packages to help, you know, make some of this a reality. So, you know, like I said at the outset, this is really just the starter pistol for the start of the race. And I think now it's really heads down and books open and pens and paper in hand. We just got to get to work doing it.
Well, Ryan, look, I know there's a lot going on. We'll have to have you back on the show as this all kind of unfolds. It'd be really good to have your voice in here as we kind of track what's happening in DC on all this stuff.
Yep, always happy to stop by for a chat.
Cool. Thanks, Ryan.
Yep, thank you.
Thanks for listening. If you want to hear the rest of the episode, you can check us out on the IBM Technology YouTube channel.